Hello everyone and welcome back. Last time we came to Bleak Falls Barrow, fought some bandits, fought some skeevers, and we came to Arvel, the Swift. Let's
talk
to him.
You did it, you killed it. Now cut me down before anything else shows up.
Where's the golden claw?
Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door and the hall of stories. I know how they all fit together. Help me down and I'll show you. You won't believe the power the Nords have hidden there.
Hand over the
claw.
Does
it look like I can move? You have to cut me down first.
Okay.
It's coming loose. I can feel it. You fool. Why should I share the treasure with anyone?
Oh. So, he was not good? As you can tell? Where are you going? You know what? I want to see how far he'll make it. Huh? Yeah. No more. He's dead. Let's go in and finish this. If you're wondering which language they speak, it's Ancient Nordic. Draugrs are a good source of bone meal and gold, honestly. They have ancient Nordic weapons. Alright, Arvel. Golden Claw. I'm not gonna read these books. Don't step on that. Actually, I'll see what happens. That happens. Just a nice little pressure plate. A little hint, if you ever see them with armor or they look slightly different than normal, it's a Draugr. Restless is definitely harder than regular. And we leveled up. However, I'm going to save this level up in case of an emergency. You may be wondering about vertical kills. Vertical kills will not activate if there are many enemies around. Is this better than what I have? No. I do like that. Alright. Draugr, bone meal, gold. Here we go, petty soul gem. Filled with a petty soul. Just because it says it's a petty soul gem does not necessarily mean it's a petty soul. Or, I guess, like, the best example would be to, like, grand. You can have a grand soul gem, but that doesn't mean you have to have a grand soul in it. Sometimes it could be something like petty in a grand, which is a complete waste of it. Because then soul gems can only be used once. One thing you can do here though, like, oh, hello. Kinnereth is a god, one of the Daedras. Alright. Further down into Bleak Falls Barrow. Gold. More gold. Meat poison. How much gold do we have? 300, wow. We came here at like 100. So we've more than tripled. Shit, we've almost quadrupled. Not here. If you want to do a little snipe, you can come up right here. Look over. Wow, I didn't expect to get that. You can throw open chests while in combat. Alright, let's continue making our way through. I don't think there's actually anything down there. So, there's no point, really. As you can see, there's a Draugr right there. Ooh, this is a Restless. So let's increase stamina this time. And we have two perks. Don't really have anything to use them on yet. I guess we could increase the amount of damage. Actually, you know what? Let's go over to restoration. Yeah, that'll be good. And then, since archery is gonna go slower, that's what I'm gonna put that in. So now it does even more. One thing that I forgot to mention. With bows, you see how it says 11, and then that's 10? The bow is already stronger than the sword, even without a perk. The bow, it does damage based on the bow plus the arrow. So since it's 11 and 10, that's 21 damage instead of 10 damage with the sword. Obviously the only drawback is the reload time. As you can see, we've already almost leveled up again. I almost got him too. If you don't pull the bow back all the way, it'll do less damage than you pulling it back all the way. You could tell, it's not like if you release it like that, one is not going to shoot as straight. Well, that's really pretty much it. Sorry about that. It doesn't shoot straight, and it's not as powerful when it hits, so, you know, obvious stuff. Alright. Here's an ancient Nordic. I already know the pattern. I believe you just hit everything twice. But if you want to know how you find out, you go to the miscellaneous, you go to the Golden Claw, zoom in on it. As you can see, it's bear, moth, owl. And then, see, bear, moth, owl. Activate keyhole. You know what? I think this will be a great time to activate quick save. See, this almost seems too weird. Which one is it? Well, if you come over here, you'll see something interesting. Word of power learned. Force, unrelenting force. This is a Draugr Overlord, a much harder version of Draugr. As you can tell, he shouts. I'm not using flames because I want to keep this on healing just in case. Speaking of healing, oh, we're gonna put up. Alright, and he's down. Dragonstone, make sure you grab that. Don't want to come back. Ancient, we can take that. Oh, Hauling. Go ahead and increase our restoration a bit more. And level up. Let's go with health. For perks, I forgot to mention, like, say we go to archery, as you can see, it requires your level to be, so you can just, like, get the final perk at, like, level 20 archery. That's not how it works. You have to limit, or they had to limit us based on, you know, what they could, and that's how they did it. Because, in reality, you could just wait till you're level 8, get 8 perks, and then there. Alright, and now we're out. Let's see where we are. We are on the other side of the mountain. But first things first, let's go to Riftwood before we go back to Dragon's Reach. Bleak Falls Barrow wasn't really that long, as you could tell. I got through it in like, what, 20 minutes total? Between 10 minutes of the last episode and 10 minutes of this episode. It's not really that long. Don't kill chickens. It's a crime. Are they open? No. No, they are not. Good time to test out the wait feature. And then open Riverwood Trader. So, returning this will not only give us more money, but will also allow one thing.
Sooner you found it! I'm gonna put this back where it belongs.
He's gonna put it back where it belongs.
You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
Right there. We got 400 gold. But now,
thank you so much for taking care of those thieves. The Riverwood Trader is back to the way it used to be.
So we can take stuff under a certain value. I don't know what the value is. I can never remember. Like coin purse, that doesn't have a value.
What are you doing that for?
I think the value is 25 or lower. I think. But yeah, you can take stuff.
The Riverwood.
And
a little
bit
of this and a bit of that.
Miscellaneous. You know, he just has different stuff. You can buy books, and these books are, you know, like the lightning and all that. But these are for like illusion. This one shows you where you need to go. Frostbite. Fury that makes them angry. This is a magic ward that protects you protects magic. Oak flesh improves your armor rating by 40 points and raise zombie.
Till next time.
Oops, wrong way. Alright, and now we're off to Dragon's Reach. Alright, here we go. Funny thing about this game, sometimes the doors will be open when you go to try to open them, and what it does is it closes it. So you need to press it twice. It's not like a major thing, but it happens occasionally.
You see? The terminology is clearly First Era or even earlier. I'm convinced this is a copy of a much older text. Perhaps dating to just after the Dragon War. If so, I could use this to cross-reference the names with other later texts.
Good. I'm glad you're making progress. My employers are anxious to have some tangible answers.
Oh, have no fear. The Jarl himself has finally taken an interest, so I'm now able to devote most of my time to this research.
Time is running, Farengar, don't forget. This isn't some theoretical question. Dragons have come back.
Yes, yes, don't worry. Although the chance to see a living dragon up close would be tremendously valuable. Now, let me show you something else I found. Very intriguing. I think your employers may be interested as well. Hmm? Ah, yes, the Jarl's protege. Back from Bleak Falls Barrow. You didn't die, it seems.
Ah, no.
The Dragon Stone of Bleak Falls Barrow. Seems you are a cut above the usual brutes the Jarl sends my way.
I bet you the Dragon Stone.
That is where
next?
Your job ends and mine begins. The work of the mind, sadly undervalued in Skyrim. My associate here will be pleased to see your handiwork. She discovered its location by means she has so far declined to share with me. So your information was correct after all. And we have our friend here to thank for recovering it for us.
You went into Bleak Falls Barrow and got that? Nice work. Just send me a copy when you've deciphered it.
Farengar, you need to come at once. A dragon's been sighted nearby. You should come too.
A dragon? How exciting. Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I don't know if I want to go see a dragon.
I'd take this a bit more seriously if I were you. If a dragon decides to attack Whiterun, I don't know if we can stop it. Let's go.
So, Irileth tells me you came from the Western Watchtower?
Yes, my lord.
Tell him what you told me about the dragon.
Oh, that's right. We saw it coming from the south. It was fast. Faster than anything I've ever seen.
What did it do? Is it attacking the watchtower?
No, my lord. It was just circling overhead when I left. I never ran so fast in my life. I thought it would have come after me, for sure.
Good work, son. We'll take it from here. Head down to the barracks for some food and rest. You've earned it. Irileth, you'd better gather some guardsmen and get down there.
I've already ordered my men to muster near the main gate.
Good. Don't fail me. There's no time to stand on ceremony, my friend.
Oh,
great. Need your help again. I want you to go with Irileth and help her fight this dragon.
Oh.
You survived Helgen, so you have more experience with dragons than anyone else here. I haven't forgotten the service you did for me in retrieving the Dragonstone for Faringar.
Didn't really do a whole lot.
As a token of my esteem, I have instructed Avanichi that you are now permitted to purchase property in the city. And please, accept this gift from my personal armory.
I should come along. I would very much like to see this dragon.
No, I can't afford to risk both of you. I need you here.
Oh, right. So we need to meet her by the Western Watchtower. And as you heard him, we could buy a house from him, which is very exciting. It's nothing too fancy. It's the cheapest house in the game, but it is good. But remember, we now have stuff that we can disenchant. So let's go ahead and disenchant this stuff. We just got a lot of levels from that. Holy crap. Let's check the enchantments. Okay, so we have frost damage, carry weight, and fortify smithing. I kind of want that. Let's put this on the gold necklace. And we have a petty soldier. It'll be 1%, but hey, 1% is better than none.
That's a decent enchantment, but keep studying. You've only scratched the surface.
When you do enchantments and stuff like that, they will actually mention your work. If it's a really nice enchantment, I believe they'll actually compliment it a lot. So now we're heading towards the Western Watchtower.
Good luck. I hope you get there in time.
Well. I didn't know she actually carried stuff. Right. So we just need to head out that way. We're gonna take a shortcut. Just jump over the entire gate. I really like this mod. It adds in like enough visual to where it looks really nice on the outside. Oh, and the trees shake. Alright, is this where we're meeting Irelith? Right there. Alright, in the next episode, we will come and continue this quest. And see what's going on with the Watchtower. I'll see you guys then.